All right, here's some Growing Life. Legend lives on from the Chippewa down of the big leg to conquer Chicago. The lake, it is said, never gives up a dead when the skies of November turn blue. With a load of iron ore, 26,000 tons more than the Edmund Fitzgerald went empty. The good ship and crew were the bone to be true when the gales of November come early. Was the pride of the American side, coming back from some hill in Wisconsin. As the big freighters go, it was bigger than most, with a crew and good captain, well seasoned, including some terms with a couple steel firms, when they left fully loaded for Cleveland. And later that night when the ship's bell rang, could it be the north wind they'd been feeling? And a wave broke over the railing, and every man knew, as the captain did too, 'twas the witch of November come stealing. The dawn came late and the breakfast had to wait when the gales of November come slashing. Supper time came, the old cook came on deck. He said, "Fellas, it's too rough to feed ya." At 7 p.m., the main hatchway caved in. He said, "Fellas, it's been good to know ya." The captain whited in, he had water coming in, and the good ship and crew was in. Came the wreck of the Edmund Fitzgerald. Does anyone know where the love of God goes when the waves turn minutes to hours? The searchers all say they have made Whitefish Bay nation. Michigan steams like a young man's dreams. He riles and bays off a sportsman. Further below Lake Ontario takes in what Lake Erie can send her. And the iron boats all go, as the mariners all know, with the gales of Sailor's Cathedral. The church bell chimed till it rang 29 times for each man on the Edmund Fitzgerald. The legend lives on from the Chippewa.